It's not an exaggeration to say that nonlinear oscillators were really responsible for a lot of the development of dynamical systems in the mid-20th century, but they weren't exactly the systems that we were looking at. What really motivated people were things called forced nonlinear oscillators. And what I mean by that is that you take all the systems that we've looked at, where you got this second-order differential equation and you set it equal to zero. Instead of that zero on the right-hand side, put in a forcing term. That is something of the form, I don't know, A cosine omega t. A is an amplitude, omega is a frequency. And what that means is that you're inputting energy into the system at a certain amplitude and with a certain frequency. It's a periodic forcing. And that can completely change the characteristics of these oscillators. For a simple example, consider the pendulum that we looked at and subject that to forcing, maybe by shaking it back and forth. And what you'll see is that that forcing term, that injection of energy into the system, gives rise to some really interesting behaviors. If instead of taking that and forcing it horizontally, shaking it back and forth, let's say we took some pendula and we shook them up and down, then depending on the magnitude and especially the frequency of that forcing, we can get changes in the stability of various equilibria that we found. There's some really fascinating stuff that goes on here. Now, you can apply forcing to any of the oscillators that we've looked at, pendula, van der Pol oscillators, but my favorite, of course, is the duffing. Because when you take some physical system that has a double well potential, let's say a bead that is sliding on a wire compressed by two springs, and you shake that system, you add some energy to it, there's enough energy to be able to overcome one of those wells. You get pushed over to the other side, and then you rock, and then you get pushed back. That looks really kind of cool and complicated. And if you pull out the long-term dynamics, if you examine X as a function of time t, you start to see some really weird behavior, stuff that looks almost random. Not quite random, but not quite ordered. It's not periodic. It's not settling into an equilibrium. What is going on? This sort of chaotic dynamics is precisely that type of fascinating behavior that inspired a lot of work in dynamical systems in the 20th century. Now, we don't know enough to be able to handle this yet. That will be our goal much later in this subject.